A recent proposal. In the background to it, we highlight something very interesting about the alternative political settlement that maybe for those who are interested, they want to embrace. The research that we are going to undertake covers four countries, Ghana, Malawi, Rwanda, and Uganda. And then what we are going to do is to examine state effectiveness. You know, the extent to which the public sector of these four countries have been effective, particularly at the turn of the century. And then when we talk about state effectiveness, we know that the state is a very large bureaucracy and we cannot study everything. So we are focusing on the core systems of the state. And there we are looking at public sector coordination. How is the entire public sector coordinated when it comes to both the distribution of resources and expenditure? Our belief is that it is not just a matter of distributing resources and then giving our policies and programs to agencies to implement, but also to have an effective state, you should have a strong center that is able to coordinate the activities. And then we're also going to look at civil service management, how recruitment and then promotions in the service, you know, is managed. We are going to look at public finance management, public sector audit, and the issues of anti-corruption. But so let me give some background to the research that we are going to carry out across the four countries. If you look at the World Governance Indicators, particularly from 2002 to 2012, it paints a very interesting picture. The interesting picture that it paints is that countries largely with competitive clientelist political settlements like Ghana and Malawi, from between 2002 and 2012, they did not do well in terms of building effective public sector institutions. But interestingly, you look at countries like Uganda and Rwanda, where you have more dominant one-party systems. You see that they were able to, at least relatively, particularly for, I think, Rwanda, and Rwanda, that country was able to improve its public sector effectiveness. And then the question that one might ask is as to whether or not it is because of their dominant one-party political system. In other words, where you have a more stable government, and ruling for a period of time and more focused on developing projects, whether that kind of system of government is more effective in terms of those and effective public sector and promoting development as compared to this kind of competitive clientelist political system where governments come and then go. And then you look at Ghana. Ghana started relatively well in 2002 and then seemed to have increased or, you know, deepened the pace of public broadly and effective public sector around 2004-2005, but from 2005 coming, it has stagnated. You know, the public sector bureaucracy, in terms of its effectiveness, it has stagnated. And then you compare the case of Ghana to Malawi, that is another clientelist political settlement. And in the case of Malawi, there shows some slight improvement. You know, they started from a worse situation than Ghana, but it has shown some slight improvement. But one might say that perhaps the political settlement that we have is not good for building an effective public sector over something for them, the developmental state, and so we should take it away and then have a more consensus form of government. But to look at the case of Uganda, you know, that also has not a dominant party system, and then the public sector bureaucracy has not really shown the kind of improvements that you see in Rwanda. So if dominant one-party systems or a more stable form of governance system does promote an effective public sector, then the question is, why haven't we seen it in Uganda? And also, this kind of contradictory picture across more competitive clientelist political systems and then the dominant party political systems, I think, generated our interest to try and investigate the factors that really promote the building of an effective public sector bureaucracy. And there are some answers, at least tentative answers, as to the pastor that proposed the building of an effective bureaucracy. And then one key answer is that when you have countries that depend, you know, strongly on donor funds, their governments do not seem to care about how their bureaucracy really functions. And so they leave the bureaucracies to rot. If you take that kind of explanation, then the question is, you look at Rwanda, and you know, that has been more dependent on donor funds, plus 19% or whatever, compared to another country like Ghana. Then one might think that maybe Rwanda's public sector bureaucracy should be weaker, because if more dependence or greater dependence of donor funds leads to a decay in the public sector, then we should find that in Rwanda, their public sector or public